वी आर गोइंग टू सी यूजीसी एनईटी मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स. ओके, सो द टॉपिक्स विच आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू आर वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड इफ यू प्रिपेयर दीज टॉपिक्स यू आर श्योरली गोइंग टू गेट वेरी गुड स्कोर इन यूजीसी एनईटी. ओके, एंड आफ्टर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस लास्ट मिनट प्रिपरेशन टिप्स. आफ्टर दैट secret strategy to qualify in UGC NET, cheat codes, okay, cheat codes to guess the correct answer in UGC NET and cutoff. Okay, let's see what are the most important topics coming to paper 1. Okay, so coming to paper 1, I'll be telling you section wise. Okay, so first section is teaching aptitude. Let's see what are the important topics under teaching aptitude. Okay, so coming to teaching aptitude, teaching objectives and characteristics, very very important. Okay, so after this you need to concentrate on learner's characteristics. Okay, learners characteristics, next important topic. Okay, so after this you need to concentrate on methods of teaching, teaching aids. Okay, what are the different types of teaching aids and evaluation systems? Okay, evaluation system. Under teaching aptitude, the topics which I gave you are really very, very important. Take a quick screenshot so that we can continue with next important topic. Okay. Research aptitude topics. Okay, so coming to research aptitude topics, steps and methods of research. Steps and methods of research, very very important. Steps and methods of research. Seminar, conference and symposium, very very important. Research ethics, very very important. Research ethics and thesis writing. Okay, so these are the most important topics coming to research aptitude. Okay, next is comprehension. Coming to comprehension, only from passages 5 questions will be asked and each question will be having 2 marks. So if you prepare passages well, 10 marks will be in your pocket. Okay, passages, most of the students will be losing time by solving passages because passages will really take a lot of time. So here I am going to give you a technique where you can solve any passage questions within less than 2 minutes. Okay, coming to passage, read questions first. Okay, most of the students, what they does is they'll read the passage completely and then they'll start reading questions. Don't do that. Read questions first and after that search the answers for these questions in the passage. Follow this technique and you can really save a lot of time. Okay, next is communication. Under communication, the most important topics are types of communication, types of communication, characteristics of communication, very very important. Okay, types of communication and characteristics of communication very, very important. Concentrate on these very well. Okay. And last but not least, barriers of communication. Barriers of communication also is very important. Effective communication, effective classroom communication. Okay, so these are very, very important. Coming to mathematical reasoning. Most prioritized concept. Okay, under series they'll ask you two different kinds of questions. They may ask you number series or alphabetical series. Okay, they may ask you any kind of series, either number series or alphabetical series or letter series. Any kind of series, they problems on relationships, very important. This is at most important, and next important topic is relationship. After this, you need to concentrate on classification problems. Okay, classifications problems and all that. Okay, so coming to logical reasoning, concentrate on verbal analogy, very important. Verbal analogy, deductive and inductive reasoning, very, very important. Venn diagram and analytical reasoning. Venn diagram, analytical reasoning. Analytical reasoning is also very important. They'll ask you logical diagram questions. Coming to reasoning. Okay, so these are the most important topics coming to logical reasoning. Okay, so now let's see what are important topics under data interpretation. Coming to data interpretation topics, you need to concentrate on quantitative and quantitative and qualitative data. Graphical representation of data and various diagrams also. Questions will be asked on various diagrams, data interpretation diagrams also. So next important topic is information and communication technology. Information and communication technology, very important. Interpretation of data. Okay, mapping of data. And they may also ask questions on various kind of quality, quantitative and qualitative topics. Okay. Next is people and environment. Coming to people and environment. People and environment interaction. People and environment interaction. Sources. What are the different sources of pollution? Okay. Impact of pollutants on human life. Very, very important on human life. Okay. Natural hazards and mitigation. And what is meant by mitigation? Controlling or trying to reduce. Okay, so let's see what are the important topics from higher education. So coming to higher education, structure of institutions. Very important for higher learning and research. Formal education and distance education. This topic is also very, very important. Governance and its administration. Okay, so these are the most important topics coming to paper 1. Okay, and paper 2 important topics will be different because there will be different subjects for different students. And coming to paper 2, you know the pattern. There will be 100 questions. Each question will contain 2 marks. So 100 questions into 2 marks is 200 marks. Okay. See what are frequently asked questions and most repeated questions coming to UGC NET. Okay. Most repeated questions and frequently asked questions. Okay. The research that aims at immediate application is dash. Okay, the research that aims at immediate application is dash. Answer is action research, because action research aims immediate application. Whatever it does, it has immediate application. Okay, 9 year old children are taller than 5 year old children. Okay, 9 year old children are taller than 5 year old children. This is example for what? Okay, this is a reference taken as example for what? This is example for the reference of dash. Okay, so the answer is cross-sectional study. Okay, answer is cross-sectional study. So coming to next question, research ethics do not include. See, I would like to tell something about this kind of questions. You need to read the question very, very carefully. Kind of tricky questions will be asked, but they are saying do not. Okay, so if you miss out reading the word do not, your answer will be wrong. So now let's see. Research ethics includes integrity. So this is not the correct answer. Objectivity and honesty. Okay, but it does not include subjectivity. So the correct answer is subjectivity. Okay. So research ethics do not include subjectivity. Next question is, a hypothesis is dash. Okay. They are asking a hypothesis as dash. It is a supposition. Supposition. Hypothesis is clearly a supposition. These are few most repeated and important questions. So now let's see last minute exam preparation tips. So first let's see What is the strategy to qualify this exam easily? Okay, UGC NET, both the papers very easily. Let's see the strategy. We all know coming to this particular exam, there are two different papers, paper 1 and paper 2. We all know that, right? If you wanted to qualify in this exam, you must get 60% in paper 1 and 60% in the paper 2. Okay, in order to qualify in this particular exam, in each of the paper, you must individually get 60% of marks. Okay, so now I'll tell you how can you get this 60% very easily without much efforts. Okay, to paper 1, we all know there are 10 units. Okay, we all know coming to paper 1, there are 10 units, and from each unit, 5 questions will be asked. 10 units, and 5 questions from each unit. So totally 50 questions. But here our target is 60%. Okay. See, out of 50 questions, if you wanted to qualify this paper 1 specially, you must get at least 30, you must at least do 30 questions correctly. You must at least answer 30 questions correctly. Okay. Till here, you understood, right? Out of 10 units, concentrate on your strength areas. Okay, out of the 10 units, first concentrate on strength areas. Okay, I'm sure out of 10 units, at least you'll be good with 6 units. Okay, I'm sure that. For example, out of 10 units, let's think you're very good at 6 units. So concentrate on these 6 units, and we all know from each unit we will be getting 5 questions. So easily 30 questions. The strategy is concentrate on strength topics. Concentrate on strength topics. At least try to answer 30 questions correctly. This is the first strategy. Attempt all the questions. Okay, so how many ever questions are there in the question paper, don't leave even single question, because we all know there is no negative marking. Okay, there is no negative marking. So even though if you don't know the answer also, try to attempt some or the other option. Start solving question paper with easy questions. Okay, so while solving question paper, start solving the paper from the easy questions. See, this is the time, exam time. Divide the exam time into 3 parts. First part of the exam time, give it for easy questions. Second, give it for moderate questions. And last, give for difficult questions, tricky questions, and for guessing. Give this time for difficult questions, tricky questions, and guessing. Okay. In the first 1/3 of the time, concentrate on solving all the easy questions and all the questions which you are very confident with. And second 1/3 of the part of exam time, give it for moderate questions. Okay. What are moderate questions? If you read the question twice or thrice, you will know the answer. Okay. Those kind of questions are moderate questions. And third part, that is at the end time of the exam, give it for difficult questions, tricky questions. Tricky questions means the questions which are asked indirectly, which needs a lot of time, those questions, okay? And for guessing, okay? And for guessing. See, let's think, out of 50 questions, you answered only 40 questions, and remaining 10 questions you didn't answer. So at this particular third part of the time, guess all the 10 questions and put some or the other answer, because we clearly know that there is no negative marking, should not even leave one question also blank, okay? And next strategy is skip lengthy questions in the beginning. Skip lengthy questions in the beginning. See, once you start writing your exam, whatever lengthy questions are there, skip them, okay? For example, if one question is taking 3 minutes, instead of solving that one question, go for easy questions which will take 1 minute for one question, okay? So in this particular exam, particularly, time management is really important, and first solve the questions which you know very well, okay? So now let's see what are the last minute preparation tips, okay? This is the strategy, last minute preparation tips, okay? Don't start new topics, okay? When you have only few days left for your exam, it's better only to revise the topics which you have already studied, okay? See, once you start new topics, you can't remember those new topics, and in return, you will also get confusion and you will also forget the topics which you have already learned, okay? So that's why don't start any new topics. Okay? And second is, time management is very, very important, okay? If you are getting stuck with any particular question or any particular concept, go to the next question, okay? Even in exam, don't waste your time by getting stuck with single questions. Mock tests are very, very important. Make sure you give your mock tests, okay? Only once you give mock tests, only you understand how much time you're taking to solve the paper, and are you getting stuck in any particular topic or question? So all these things you will understand in mock tests, and only with the help of mock tests you will understand what are the common mistakes you are making, so that you'll make sure you will not repeat those mistakes in the final exam, okay? So mock tests are very, very important. Read each and every question carefully. Next important tip is read questions carefully. The few questions will be tricky, and few questions will be asking, like, they'll ask, select the option which does not include, okay? If you didn't read does not or do not option, you will read it as select the option which includes, so that your answer will be wrong and you will lose marks. That's why read every question carefully. Solve at least last 4 to 5 years of previous papers, so you'll understand what level of questions are asked in the exam. Okay, so next is always maintain your speed and accuracy. What is speed? We already know it's nothing but time management. Accuracy means if you are solving 10 questions in 10 minutes and at least 7 questions are correct, then it means you have accuracy. Okay. Now I'm going to tell you exam day tip. Coming to exam day tips, don't forget your admit card, ID card also, ID proof also, you need to take a valid ID proof. A valid ID proof means Aadhaar card or voter ID, driving license, all this comes under valid ID proofs. Only valid ID proofs will be allowed in the exam. Okay, that's why make sure you carry your admit card, ID card, as well as at least 2 to 3 passport size photos. Okay, these are really important. and make sure you reach exam hall, exam center at least before 1 hour. There will be a lot many protocols which you need to undergo, thermal screening, all those things. So it will surely take some time. So better reach your exam center at least before 1 hour of time. Okay. To the cutoff. Cutoff will be different for different subjects. So coming to economics. Cutoff will be 75% marks. Okay, I'm telling cutoff in the form of percentage marks. Okay, 75. And coming to political science, cutoff is going to be 65 plus. Okay, coming to philosophy, cutoff is going to be 73 plus, and coming to psychology, 65 plus. To sociology, cutoff is going to be 71. 71 plus. Coming to history, cutoff is going to be around 62. And coming to commerce, cutoff is going to be 68. Coming to commerce, cutoff is going to be 68 plus. Coming to public administration, cutoff is going to be 65 plus. Coming to management, cutoff is going to be 68 plus. To environmental sciences, coming to environmental sciences, cutoff is going to be 65. These are the expected cutoffs. However, cutoffs will be different based on the difficulty level of the paper and performance of the students. If the paper difficulty is really high, then cutoff will come down. If the paper is very easy, then cutoff will increase in values. Next cheat code is no extreme values. What does this mean? For example, let's think there is a question and there are four options. Option A is 2, option B is 4, option B is 8, option D is 21. Okay, so see, out of these four options, which is having extreme value? Extreme means different value. This is having different value, so you can't put this as answer. Okay, you have to put only one of these three options as the answer. Okay, you should avoid extreme values. Okay, do no extreme values. E cheat code kar dvaitte ipudu manam chuddam. Okay, so for question undi and four options icharu, 2, 4, 8, 21, idi four values. Aa four values lo మొత్తం డిఫరెంట్ గా విభిన్నంగా ఉన్న ఆప్షన్ ఏదైతే ఉంది, ఇది 21. మిగిలినవన్నీ దగ్గర దగ్గరగా ఉన్న ఆప్షన్స్, కానీ ఇది మాత్రం చాలా డిఫరెంట్ గా ఉంది. ఇలాంటి డిఫరెంట్ ఆప్షన్ ని మాత్రం పెట్టుకోవద్దు. గెస్ చేస్తున్నప్పుడు దీన్ని అవాయిడ్ చేయండి. మిగిలిన త్రీలోనే ఒక ఆన్సర్ అనేది మీరు పెట్టుకోవచ్చు. ఓకేనా? సో నెక్స్ట్ వచ్చేసి ఆల్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌవ్, నన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబౌవ్. Next is all of the above, none of the above. See, when you have all of the above as one of the option, you can go for it. You have all of the above as one of the option and you don't know what is the correct answer, then there are high chances that all of the above is the correct answer. Then you can happily go for it. Okay. And if you find none of the above as one of the option and if you don't know what is the correct answer, don't go for it. Okay. There are very least probabilities of none of the above being the correct answer. Okay, so that's why always go for all of the above and never go for none of the above. Okay, so ipudu manam all of the above, none of the above options ento chuddam. Okay, oka question undi, a question options vachesi all of the above undi అండ్ మీకు ఆన్సర్ కరెక్ట్గా తెలియకపోతే అప్పుడు మీరు ఆల్ ఆఫ్ ది అబవ్ అనేది పెట్టొచ్చు, ఎందుకంటే చాలా ఛాన్సెస్ ఉన్నాయి ఆల్ ఆఫ్ ది అబవ్ కరెక్ట్ అవ్వడానికి. సో ఇలాంటప్పుడు మీరు ఆల్ ఆఫ్ ది అబవ్ ఆప్షన్ చూస్ చేసుకోవచ్చు. సెకండ్ ఏంటంటే, మీకు మీకు ఇచ్చిన ఆప్షన్స్లో నన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబవ్ ఉంది అండ్ మీకు ఆ కరెక్ట్ ఆన్సర్ తెలియదు అన్నప్పుడు నన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబవ్ చూస్ చేసుకోకండి, ఎందుకంటే చాలా తక్కువ కేసులో, చాలా తక్కువ ఛాన్సెస్లో నన్ ఆఫ్ ది అబవ్ అనేది కరెక్ట్ ఆన్సర్ అవుతుంది. సరేనా? నెక్స్ట్ వచ్చేసి ఎలిమినేషన్ మెథడ్. నెక్స్ట్ ఈజ్ ఎలిమినేషన్ మెథడ్. సో వాట్ ఈస్ ఎలిమినేషన్ మెథడ్? వెన్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఫోర్ ఆప్షన్స్, యూజింగ్ యువర్ లాజిక్, యూజింగ్ ద కాన్సెప్ట్ విచ్ యూ నో విచ్ ఇస్ రిలేటెడ్ టు దిస్ క్వశ్చన్, ట్రై టు ఎలిమినేట్ ద irrelevant options. Okay, so then out of four options, after eliminating the irrelevant options, you will be left with only two options. Then you can happily guess and put one of these options. Okay, this is called elimination method, using your logic and your common sense and the concept which you know related to the question, just eliminate irrelevant options. Okay, so ippudu manam elimination method ante ento chuddam. ఎలిమినేషన్ మెథడ్ ఏంటంటే, ఒక క్వశ్చన్లో ఫోర్ ఆప్షన్స్ ఇస్తే మీకు ఆ కాన్సెప్ట్, మీకు ఆ క్వశ్చన్కి సంబంధించిన కాన్సెప్ట్ గుర్తు తెచ్చుకొని కామన్ సెన్స్ ఉపయోగించుకుని ఫోర్ ఆప్షన్స్లో టూ ఆప్షన్స్ మీరు ఎలిమినేట్ చేసేయండి, రిమూవ్ చేసేయండి. అప్పుడు మిగిలిన ఆప్షన్స్లో ఒక ఆన్సర్ మీరు పెట్టొచ్చు కరెక్ట్గా గెస్ చేసి. దీన్నే ఎలిమినేషన్ మెథడ్ అంటారు. For giving best videos for you people, me and my team is working so much hard for you people. So yeah, please support us, subscribe and hit the bell icon, and also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end, and all the very best to your exam. Thanks for watching.